بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أنبياء الله جميعا وعلى سيدهم وخاتمهم حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيت الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الذين آمنوا والذين هادوا والنصارى والصابئين من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر وعمل صالحا فلهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون صدق الله العلي العظيم. What is the stand of Islam on previous religions, on Christianity and Judaism? What does Islam say about that? What would be the fate of their followers, those who follow Judaism, Christianity and other religions? What would God do with them on the Day of Judgment? And is paradise only reserved for the Muslims? Some people say paradise is only for the Sunnis. And the Wahhabis believe paradise is only for them. Sufis believe that paradise is only for them. The Shi'as believe that paradise is only for them. So, where is the answer? Where is the right answer in the Holy Quran? Three verses in the Quran are very critical in regards to the fate of the followers of other religions. This is one of them that I recited, which is in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 62, earlier, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا those who believed, meaning the Muslims. وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا the Jews. وَالنَّصَارَى the Christians. وَالصَّابِئِينَ Sabians. مَنْ آمَنَ those of them who believe in God and hereafter. مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ this is the belief side of it. And then there is another type, another side, another part. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا and does righteous. فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ their reward, meaning their positive reward, they're going to find it there with their Lord. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ no grief shall be upon them. وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ they should never be worried about their fate. So this is one verse. The second one in Surah Al-Ma'idah, same, almost the same meaning. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالصَّابِئُونَ وَالنَّصَارَى here, Sabians, they come before Christians. And the first one, Christians and Sabians. And this one, وَالصَّابِئُونَ وَالنَّصَارَى مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ same sentence. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا and does righteous. فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ another verse in Surah Al-Hajj, chapter 22, in Surah Al-Hajj, verse number 17, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالصَّابِئِينَ وَالنَّصَارَى then they add one more item, one more group are added to, in this verse to the same group, وَالْمَجُوسِ Magians, وَالْمَجُوسِ وَالَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا the pagans too. So the people who believe and the people who rejected belief. أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا and in between the Christians, the Jews, the Sabians, the Magians. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٌ Allah is going to judge among them. Judge among them, it means Allah is going to decide their fate. So we have two questions here. What would be their fate? Or you have friends, many of them are Christians, there could be some Jews among them, there could be some other religions among them, and many of those friends are super good, not just good, but super good, very close to you. I know definitely some of your neighbors are very good. And you feel affinity, you feel you have positive feeling, good feelings regarding them. They help you, they are very helpful. I know some friends during the month of Ramadan, some Christian friends, I personally know them. For so many years they have been fasting. Why? In solidarity with Muslims. They say this is the least thing we can do to our Muslim neighbors and brothers and sisters, is to observe fasting to show solidarity and respect. They fast, some of them they fast one day, some of them they fast 1 week, and one or a couple I know they fast the whole month. They've been fasting, they are from the Mormon church, they've been fasting for the last 10 days, the whole month of Ramadan. And they are good Christians, and they are proud of their Christianity. So what is their fate? Allah says their fate, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامِ. Our duty, responsibility here is to follow this specific tradition. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Allah says Islam is the final version of my faith. I have faith. And that faith, that message went through certain periods and eras. One era was called Shari'atu Nuh, the faith of Nuh, the law of Nuh. He came thousands of years ago and he had certain rules and regulations. After Nuh, we had Ibrahim, and Ibrahim had a book. صحف إبراهيم وموسى. He had صحف, he had a book, scripture, and he had certain sharia and certain rules. After Ibrahim, we had موسى عليه السلام. Again, موسى came with the Torah. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَا التَّوْرَاةَ فِيهَا نُورٌ. Allah says in Torah, there is light, there is guidance. After Isa, after موسى came Isa. وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ مُصَدِّقًا. His job had two faults. Isa, his responsibility was A and B. A, مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ. I came to confirm the teachings and reaffirm the teachings of the Torah. I have no law. I'm not bringing a new law. He had a book, but his book, the Injil, the Gospel, it's not a law book. I came to reaffirm the teachings, the law of Moses. مُصَدَّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ. This is A. B, what was B? Yes. In Surah As-Saff. مُصَدَّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ and وَمُبَشِّرًا وَمُبَشِّرًا, giving glad tidings to the next generations. وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَد. His title, his name is Ahmed. So God's message is one. The fundamentals of his message are one. Monotheism, based on monotheism, based on the belief in the Day of Judgment. And of course there are certain details. Some of these details are prayers, fasting, because fasting has been prescribed to all communities. No community, God said to them, listen, you don't fast, eat 12 months a year. No, definitely they have. But maybe not exactly the way we fast, maybe not the same period. Some of them longer, 40 days, some of them shorter. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Communities before you, had to fast too. Not just you. Fasting is not something new. Zakat, charity also, they all had to give zakat. Jihad, struggling in the way of God. So, but then there was some differences, minor differences. لِكُلٍّ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا. Every community of Moses, Jesus, before him Abraham, Noah, they had certain rules and regulations that suits their situation and their needs. But then came the Quran as the final book, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the final messenger. Khatam al-Anbiya. His title is Khatam al-Anbiya. So there were some changes, but the core of the message is exactly the same. Allah says, now my final message now, at this time, from the time 1400 years ago onward, it's Islam. This is my final message. Now whether people who are non-Muslims now, whether they go to hell or heaven, this is not my business. Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. That does not mean that they are legitimate and you have to, it's okay, because some people say, well, the verse, if the verse says they are all good, then I remain Christian. What's wrong with that? Parallel to Islam, there are other religions, Christianity, Judaism, Islam, you know, Sabians, Magians. They are all, they lead to God. I'll come to the explanation of this verse. Now Allah says, my final version is Islam. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ لَهُ. If you try to follow other than Islam, this Islam, the religion of, the religion that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam preached, this is the meaning of Islam. فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ لَهُ. It's not going to be accepted from him or her. On the Day of Judgment, they're going to be losers. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. However, now what will happen to them on the Day of Judgment, that belongs to Allah. It belongs to Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could admit all people into hellfire, and He can admit all of them into paradise. He is Malik Yawm al-Din. He is the superior court and the superior judge. And His decision is irrevocable. And nobody can challenge Him on that day. It's like you go to someone's house, someone's farm, he owns it 100%, and he says, listen, I'm the owner. I decide where you sit. I decide where you go. I decide where you sleep. This is my property. This entire universe belongs to him. So he decides. He decides. But always, always remember, his rahmatuhu sabaqat ghadabah. His mercy takes precedence over his wrath. So his mercy comes first, not his wrath. God is not the God of anger or wrath or revenge or hate. He's the God of mercy. And if sometimes he gets angry, it's because of us. Because we do stupid things. It's like the mother who loves her children very much, but sometimes she gets angry and frustrated because they are not listening. They are endangering their life. She gets angry because of them, not because of her. Because she wants to save them. When Allah becomes angry because He wants to save us, we are not hurting Him. He's not going to lose anything if we don't worship Him. Neither He gains anything if we worship Him. Allah is Allah, the same. The same. Nothing would reduce Him. Nothing would increase Him. this increases, the reduces, it happens to us. One day we feel that we are important, we are big, because somebody said, I love you today, or what a good job you did, so I feel I am very important. Another day we feel down because people, they disappointed us today. Nobody praised me today. I feel down. I'm a human being. God is different. God does not have these feelings. So, where are we going to go on that day? This is his business, not our business. Not only regarding Jews and Christians, even Muslims. Who can say all Muslims go to paradise? Nobody can say that. And nowhere is in the Quran Allah says all Muslims are going to go to paradise. Allah always, when He speaks about paradise, He says, Man amana wa amila salihan. It's not just by names, by titles. He's a Muslim, he's a Shi'a, he's a Wahhabi, he's Salafi, he's Sufi. It's not about that. It's about deeds. It's about faith and deed, not titles. Not titles. Because Allah says some of the Jews, they used to say, be only a Jewish person, you're going to survive. وَقَالُوا كُونُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا تَحْتَدُوا. Just carry the title of being a Jew or a Christian, it suffices you. You don't need to work. Allah says, no, that does not work. Neither it would work if you just carry the title of being Muslim. It would not help you. Allah needs to see work, work being done, achievements. What is your achievement? Show me. Show me. Don't tell me my name was this, my family was this, I belong to this prophet, I'm the descendant of that prophet, I lived in this religious city, I come from this family. I don't care about this. I look at your amal. I'm imam and amal. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. So, Jews, again Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, they said, وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَا النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودًا. Even if God decides to send us to hellfire, then the fire would not touch us only except for a number of days. إِلَّا أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودًا. You know how God answers them? Beautiful answer. Allah says, Allah refutes them. Allah says, قُلْ أَتَّخَذْتُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَهْدًا. You signed a contract with God that He would not punish you only for a few days? Where is this contract? Show me. Who said God is not going to punish you except for a few days? It's up to him. It's up to him whether he punishes or not. It's up to him whether it's a life sentence or one day. It's up to him. You don't decide for God his job. You don't teach him his job. فَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ عَهْدَهُ أَمْ تَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, this is very important that we adhere to it, we the Muslims. وَقَالُوا, people of book, during the time of the Prophet, they said, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. Paradise has been booked completely, sometimes overbooked. Have you seen some airplanes when you arrive at the desk, they tell you it's overbooked? They say paradise is overbooked only for Jews and Christians. مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. Allah says, تِلْكَ أَمَانِيُّهُمْ. This is their wishful thinking. أَمَانِيُّهُمْ, dreams. These are dreams. أَمَانِيُّهُمْ. قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ. Show me, where did He say that paradise is only for Jews or Christians? قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you are truthful, show me the evidence. And then He says this, we have to listen to this, the Muslims. God did not say paradise. No, 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 it's not for Jews and Christians. It's only for the Muslims. He never said that. What He said is this. He says, Bala, nevertheless. Man aslama wajhahu lillah. Paradise is for those who submit themselves completely to the will of God. Islam, this is the meaning of Islam. Meaning of Islam is I don't argue with God. I do not defy God. I do not counter God. Sometimes I may say to him, God, I want to understand this more, but I don't defy him. بَلَا مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. Why? He's a benevolent. Muhsin comes from ihsan, and ihsan is beloved, benevolence. Ihsan is wholesomeness. Ihsan is goodness and kindness. You have to do ihsan in this case. فَلَهُ أَجْرُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ. See, it's a reference to two things. بَلَا مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ is a reference to what? Can you tell me? The first sentence. Allah says there are two prerequisites to make it to paradise. One, بَلَا, nevertheless, مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ. Paradise is the one who submits himself totally and completely before God. It's a reference to what? Put it in one word, one term. And that term begins with F. Good F, not bad. Huh? F with A, with I, with T, with H. This is Iman. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And then the second one, a reference to what? وَهُوَ مُحْسِن. Muhsin is benevolence. It's a reference to what? Ihsan is reference to what? Huh? Amal, good deeds. Good deeds. This is throughout the Quran. Sometimes the Quran uses the term faith, iman. Sometimes he alternates between iman and sometimes he says Islam. Submission, which is the same as faith. And sometimes he says al-amal al-salih, sometimes he says ihsan, which is the same, good deeds. Allah never said only Muslims go to paradise. He says Muslims plus two things, real faith and real work, real production. So at the end of the day, what is the answer then? Where does those people go? Many churches, nice people, God-fearing, law-abiding, they love their neighbors, they help. You know how many Christian charities are sending food now, are sending food to the Syrian people, Syrian refugees, Iraqi refugees. Saudi Arabia is sending missiles and bombs to Yemen, and the Christian charities are sending food and medicine. And God does not see these things? He's blind? He doesn't see? Definitely He does. Allah says in the Quran, there is a very important verse in the Quran. You have to memorize it. And I know you all memorize it. You all memorize it. That gives you a lot of answers in this regard. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. If the son of the prophet, he does wrong and evil, he shall see the result of his evil. If the son of the Satan does good job, good deeds, he shall see the result of his good deeds. That has nothing to do with race, with blood, with title, with I am Muslim, I am non-Muslim. Allah says, good deeds, you will see the result of your good deeds. And bad deeds, even if you consider yourself to be Muslim, to pray five times a day, to fast during Ramadan, to memorize the Quran, but you are abusing others, killing others, doing injustice to others, you shall see the result of your bad deeds. Those people, we don't have an answer. If someone tells you, what do you think of me? I'm a Jew. Tell him if you are. This is the answer in the Quran. Answer exactly. Show him Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 62. Immediately show him the Quran. Tell him, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَى وَالصَّابِئِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Allah says, if during the time of their prophets they did well, then definitely their places in paradise. Now, if they are doing well, we don't know about paradise now. We can't decide. Neither we can say they're going to go to hell. This is, the answer is reserved only for God. Because God knows about the hearts and the intentions. However, our duty as people, we have to follow Islam. Because Allah says to the people of the book, during the time of the Prophet, He says to them, listen, your Judaism, your Christianity has expired. Has expired. The time of it has expired. We sent a messenger. You should not be arrogant. You should humble yourself. And if you claim to love God, then listen to God. Do not disobey God. Listen to Him and follow this Prophet. Follow this book, the Holy Quran. The Quran says to them, this is the wording of the Quran in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 48. وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ. We sent this book upon you with the truth. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. This book confirms the earlier scriptures, Gospel, Torah, Suhuf Ibrahim, Dawood alayhi salam, the Psalm of David. It confirms them. This book is not a deviation from these books, earlier books. It's a confirmation. It's a confirmation. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ. And then listen to this. وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ. Now, the leadership now is for this book. مُهَيْمِنْ هَيْمَنْ. Leadership. So this book now governs other books. This is the most updated version of God's divine message. So they have to follow this. They have to follow. But on the day of judgment, what God is going to do, we really don't know. Some people are going to be disappointed. They think, wow, I'm a Muslim, I pray 5 times a day, I never miss Ramadan. On the day of judgment, they tell them, go into that direction. Jahannam. This is in the Quran. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. All the amal that they did in this life, we destroyed it. We completely destroyed it. Annihilated their deeds. Destroyed their deeds. هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. On the other hand, some people, they come, they really don't know. They are worried. Allah says, I will embrace you with my mercy. Because of one single act you did in this dunya. I'm not going to look at all your record and examine it. You know, I'm not going to say I'm sending you to paradise because you never missed the prayers or fasting. I'm going to send you to paradise because you saved the life, sometimes not the life, the dignity of a human being. They came one day to the Prophet, they said, Ya Rasulullah, one of his companions, he comes to the mosque, we see him in the mosque. We saw him torturing a cat. Cat! Denying the cat the drink, the water, until it died thirsty. The Prophet said he will go to hellfire. He didn't kill a human being. He caused the death of an animal, cat. The Prophet said he goes to the hellfire. Because Allah could save a person from fire by saving an animal, or He can send a person to a fire because he killed an animal. Now, what do you think about someone who kills a human being? Many human beings, many women, many children, during the month of Ramadan, in bombings, aerial bombings, suicide bombings, inside the mosque, in the marketplace, outside. And he says, I'm Muslim. He says, I'm Muslim. And he memorizes the Quran. And some mashayikh, they are supporting the Sultan, praying for him, praying for more aggression that he commits. Allah says, never. My system is based on fairness, justice, and compassion. That's my branch. So paradise is reserved for those who have faith and do good. And ultimately on the day of judgment, the mu'min always should live in a state, in a mixed feeling. On the one hand, hope in God's forgiveness. On the second hand, he has to be worried. State of fear of God's punishment. Al-mu'minu bayna al-khawfi wa al-raja. On the one hand, we have to have hope in God that after all what I did, really he's going to punish me. I submit myself to him. The hadith says, a single drop of tears in the middle of the night, من خشيت الله, out of reverence to him, love, تطفئ بحارا من غضب الله, extinguishes oceans of God's wrath. You can extinguish that with one single drop of tears, sincere tears. God of mercy. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات إنك مجيب الدعوات اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا ودعاءنا وتهجدنا وطاعتنا في هذا الشهر العظيم. Only few days left of this month, maybe 7 or I don't know, maybe Friday is going to be Eid or Saturday. So few days, take advantage of them. Don't spoil them. If you still had not done what you're supposed to do, you have less than 1 week ahead of you to strengthen your ties with your Lord. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا.